Hello everyone and welcome to our channel Learn Project Management on YouTube. And today is going to be lecture number 9 on the progress update on the latest revision of Primavera P6 version 18. And in our channel we'll give free courses for advanced and beginner for P6, and today is going to be the last lectures in the beginner, and we're going to start from next time on the advanced levels, which we're gonna go to the resource leveling, earned value and the KPI, and how to tie Excel with Primavera, how you export and import the KPI, and also actual experience from project all over the world. It will give you the template, will help you downloading the software, and you're gonna be an expert and you can get a good job. Also, we'll give courses in PMP, risks and Six Sigma, and I'm doing my best to add the lecture in English and in Arabic in the same day for the benefit of all. The intention is to give hand and to make everyone very expert in this program, also in project management, to get a good job in this difficult time. Also, we are doing our best to share all the jobs that we got on all the Facebook groups and on my website and everywhere. We are sharing the jobs so that everyone can see it and apply for the job. Okay. Our channel in YouTube is like that. You're gonna find English lectures, which is all the lecture that I have done in English in Primavera P6 version 18, and there's another playlist in Arabic for who interested in Arabic, and another overview of the channel, the sample lectures that we have added so far for PMP, Risk and Six Sigma. We're gonna improve that to have the advanced levels and also the beginner levels, and also template from project and project management lectures only also. Again, here how to download the latest revision from edelivery.oracle.com for Primavera. This is a legal version. This is a legal version for education and personal use only. It is not for business. So this is the license of this. Okay. And I already downloaded this in my Google Drive and I added under many videos. So the software is ready. I have already downloaded also the P6 EPPM also version around 1.4 giga. I already downloaded in my Google Drive, and also a sample of highway project with all the templates, the PDF, the descriptions, all of that on my Google Drive, and I shared it before and I'm gonna share it again under this video. By end of this course, we'll do a complete project from creating the WBS until we do the update. I am gonna do a bridge project, and we're gonna see the drawing, the contract condition, everything together. And if you have any comment, let me know. If you need something else, let me know. And this is gonna be soon. We have talked before about create the baseline and how you assign the baseline. These are lectures. I'm gonna add it below this video about how to create a baseline, because it is very important before starting doing the update to have your baseline ready for you. Updating the project schedule. This is a system that you should agree with your project manager as with your contract. How often you're gonna do the progress update, what methods you're gonna use, what information you need from the foreman, from the project manager, from the site team, who will gather the necessary information, who is going to do that, how you will get the information from the site guys, and what template you use. So always make it simple to get the help and the feedback from the guys on site. Don't make it very complicated and the spreadsheet with hundreds of columns. None of the guys will help you and give you any information. So you have to agree how you're gonna do that, okay, and who is gonna do this, and you have to do a procedure and the process how you will get all your information with a good system, easy for everyone, to collect and give you the feedback and help you update your schedule. We said that you have to identify the information, you're gonna need the resources, you're gonna need also the activities start and finish date, and also you need to get, if you have timesheets for equipment and for yourself, if your company using a timesheet to update the schedule, also you have to get the timesheet. So we said for the timesheet is the progress reporters and the, how to tie this with P6. This is very advanced, but if you need guys and or if you have any project that is using a timesheet modules, let me know and I will give some lectures how to do that in P6. Some people are tying this to accounting systems so that you can have your cost and all this kind of information. Also, if you are using that, let me know and I'm gonna help on that. How often you gonna update the schedule? You're gonna make it daily, weekly, monthly, based on you, the importance of your project. Some turnaround project in oil and gas are doing by hourly because it's very important to have all your part, valves, everything on time so that you to avoid any shortcut, and any delay 1 hour is gonna be a lot of cost. So it is based on the importance of your project and the contract conditions, how often you're gonna do the update. So methods of updating, are you gonna update all activity and resources as a whole, or you're gonna update only the activity and the resources individually, or you're gonna update the progress from the timesheet, or you're gonna use a combination of all these methods? This is all again based on the contract condition, the agreement between you and the project manager and the client, and the importance of your project. So the update progress should include all of that. I'm not gonna read the slide. I'm gonna go to the live software and we're gonna discuss everything. So it should be a procedure in your company system about how to update the schedule and how often you do that. Okay, and you should have a busy plan. And there is an option in P6 to update your schedule automatically, and I don't prefer that. You use this only when your actual work match your baseline, so you are progressing your project as per your plan, and this is never happened anywhere in my career or any other project. So our focus is gonna be on the actual and the manual updating the schedule. You're gonna update the actual start and finish date, actual resource cost and estimated remaining to complete, and also project actuals. So all this kind of stuff and leveling the resource, but it's gonna be something in the advanced level I'm gonna do after we update and create a complete project. Okay, you have to know what percent complete you use. In P6, you have three types of percent complete. The physical percent complete, and you have the duration percent complete, and you have the units percent complete. I have given a complete lecture about the difference between the three, but if you still have any questions, let me know, and I will answer, I'll help you about that. So if you are working in an important project or the budget of the project is very high, you're gonna update the dates, you're gonna update the units, you're gonna update the cost, and some companies are using P6 to do the P applications, the invoices also, so it is gonna be based on what method you are gonna use. So I will explain the percent complete type very fast when we go to the live software. But the steps, as we said, you're gonna add actual date, remaining duration is very important. I have never seen in the latest videos of some people, they don't update the remaining duration. They are giving some videos and some courses, and this is really give feedback for who, anyone who is following them. Remaining duration is very important, and if you don't update your remaining duration, you didn't do your update. This is very important. I'm gonna repeat it many times because I have seen a lot of videos. They have just go and update some dates and they put the percent complete and they said, okay, good, I have already done the update. This is not right. After you do that, you're gonna do F9 for calculations, and the program is gonna calculate for you the earliest date, remaining date, and all your unit. After that, you're gonna move the data date, by the way, if you are recording your progress end of April, so you add all your informations, and then you do F9, you change the data date, and the program is gonna explain and give you all the informations of the update. And also you can print the report. I will show maybe one or two lectures how to do the report, because this is very important. Based on the level of people that you are presenting the report, it should be different. The executive people is gonna have only summary, the project manager gonna have detailed, so the client is gonna have different kind of report. So the reporting in P6 and how you do the monthly report or the weekly report, I think it's gonna need two or three lectures explaining how you do that and to get the client attentions, and also you be successful in your work. So now we are on the live software, Primavera P6 version 18, and I will go here to the layout and I will collapse it all. This is the office building that we have talked about before, and here's the WBS. You can see here from design, engineering, foundation, structure, mechanical, exterior, and interior. If you don't have this revision, let me know. I will send it to you, or I will add it again under my Google Drive for you guys. So before updating any activities, I have just updated the foundation wall today in the Arabic lecture that I have already downloaded in my channel, but I'm gonna do again here in English. You have to go the general tab and you understand your activity. What is the activity type? It is task dependent or level of effort or start milestone. Duration type, keep it default as it is. This is an important one, percent complete type. What percent complete you have? We said we have duration, physical, and units, and you should know what is the difference between these and how we can use that. Which calendar this activity is working on it? What WBS? Who is the responsible manager? Who is the primary resource? And who is going to give you the update on this activity? Is it clear now? You have to go to the general, understand the activity, and understand all the information. After that, you have to go to the status here, the status tab, and you will go and update from here. In the status tab, you can find the activity ID, the activity name, and you will find here the original duration, actual duration, remaining duration, and at complete, total float, and free float. So if you look for this activity here, you will find at completion is 70 days, but the original is 24. That means this activity is delayed a lot. Okay, and you're gonna find here total float is 72. However, the free float is 0. Free float means that the activity can be delayed without delaying the success. Total float means activity, if delayed, it will delay the project completion date, and it will affect the critical path. Okay, how we update the activities? Let me go to the form work and post lab. I will find this activity. I will find this activity original duration 12, remaining 12, at completion 12, and here the total float. So let me go and do start, and then I will go. This activity is supposed to start in October 27, 2011. I'm gonna do it here, by the way. Make it 27 September as an actuals. Okay, and the program is gonna tell you how many days actual duration that this activity have, and how many remaining duration to finish this activity. Based on the resources I have, based on the discussions, the information come from site. I'm gonna, by the way, do this 15 days as the remaining durations, and I will run the schedule. And I will change the data date to make it, by the way, 27 September. Okay, and you will see right now here, because I have out of sequence, this is why it shows like that here. I didn't update all the activities. So the important thing here is to add the remaining duration. If you, and here also we forgot to do, by the way, the percent complete 20%. So now I have added the actual start, and added the percent complete, and added the remaining duration. Okay, If the activity is completed, I'm gonna make this finish here. I will complete finish. If it is not complete, you have to go to the actual dates, percentage, and then the remaining duration. And you can see here that at complete is 85. That means this project is taking 2 to 3, 4 times the actual durations. And that means the resources on this activity is not working very well. Okay, so now we have updated this activity, and we're adding the actual dates, and we're adding here the percent complete and the remaining duration, and the program give me the finish date, the expected finish date for this activity. Okay, let me go for the other one here, backfill. I will do the backfill, by the way, starting here in September. I will start, and I will do it here. I can make it September, by the way, 21, and then I will add it 50% complete, and I will add the remaining duration around 10 days. After that, I will go and make F9 so that the program can calculate. Can you see this now on the screen? This is very, very important, and some of the people, or many of the people, don't understand that. If you find the activity started like this, and you still have a portion here, you have out of sequence. You have out of sequence activities, and the program is gonna get the remaining duration of this activity, which is 10 days, after the other activity is complete. Okay, so any gaps in the schedules, for sure you have a problem. This is very good, and the trick, if I look for any schedule and I found this like that, I'm gonna reject the schedule. If you have any gaps, that means you have a problem and you have out of sequence. And I said before, we're gonna talk about all these tricks and functions in the expert levels and advanced level in P6 that we're gonna start from next lectures. So in this class, you have learned how to update the schedules, and also I have gone through some of the slides. I hope you like the video and you share it with everyone need help, because the intention is to help everyone, and giving you the free software, giving you the free example of the project, so that you can get a good job, and we have to do something good for our life. So if you like the video, so please, you can subscribe if this is the first time for you, and hit the bell and to get all the update, because if you didn't hit this bell, whenever I added any lecture, you will not get any notification. So you have to do that, so that you will get all the notifications of my lectures, and you can share it with everybody. And thanks so much for watching, and see you guys in the next level of Primavera P6 version 18 in the advanced level. I hope you like that and share it with everyone who need help. And thanks so much, and have a great day, and see you.